Hello, welcome to Dhaksh tutorials. Today I'm going to tell you about WordPress. So to install WordPress, what are all required and what is WordPress exactly, everything will be knowing in this tutorial. So first, what is a WordPress? WordPress is nothing but it is a CMS. CMS means content management system. There are many CMS available, but WordPress is highly used nowadays in the web platform. WordPress is a very free source. It's a free and open source, and it is widely used to develop and design websites and also to host a web server. Everything we are very much using WordPress these days. So what does WordPress do? WordPress works with the help of PHP, MySQL and Apache server. So PHP is a language and MySQL is the database, and server Apache server. So to run a WordPress, you need to have these three things in your system. But no worry, you don't worry that I don't know PHP, I don't know MySQL, I don't know how to do things with Apache, everything. So do not worry for that. There are some packages available, like there are some softwares like WAMP and XAMPP servers are there for Windows, and they also, if you are running on Mac, OS or anything, then you can go for WAMP. So these servers in by default have this PHP, MySQL and Apache servers. So I will be using here WAMP. I will not be using XAMPP and anything, because mine is a Windows and I am good with, I will be liking much with WAMP. So I would be using WAMP server in this. So first, to install WAMP server, go to your Google Chrome. You can just on or any, you can Google it saying WAMP server free download, anything. So you will be getting the WAMP server's web page. You can go to any of these links. You can just go to here and start using WAMP server download. Here it is, the download option. Just go. Okay, then if you want to use, go for your 32-bit, go install 32 or a 64. To know whether your system is 32 or 64-bit configuration, just open your My Computer, go to your My PC, and then just go to the properties. And here you could see system type as 64, mine is 64. If yours is 32, just install that particular version. So mine is 64, just click on that. You want to download directly. Okay, just come down here. You will be having all the things like latest one, anything. So I just go and download this. You can download anything, but it should be latest one. So just download here, click on that, download latest version. The download will start shortly. It is downloading. So you can download other versions also, but other versions will not help you much, because there may be a new updates or anything. There may be some applications will be deprecated, all those things will be happening. So always prefer to download or use the software which are of latest versions. This will take some time to download. So your WAMP server, once it gets downloaded, you will be having all the things by default, your PHP, MySQL and a server. But why do you need your MySQL actually? Database. When in any websites, if you want to see, suppose you will be saying in your websites like contact us or send feedback. So how you will be sending, you will be just writing your name, email and your feedback, and then you will get send. So when you say, but press the button send, that information should be stored in your database, so that your web, the particular company website or any other person administrator should view that. So to see those websites, the data and everything, the data should be stored somewhere. So that is what your MySQL, the database, does that for you. And server, it should be like some server should be running, and that is the Apache server. And PHP, here in PHP, by using PHP, we'll be doing all these things in your WordPress. So once your WAMP server gets installed, then we will have to download our WordPress and then install our WordPress by giving the WordPress admin name, login details, and then you have to install your WordPress there. Okay. So meanwhile, we'll also download WordPress here. Just press WordPress down. Download WordPress, even that will be getting downloaded. Well, until the meantime, we'll be see it got downloaded, and just click on this. Install anyway. Just select the language. I do accept. Next. And by default, your WAMP server for the PHP my admin, there should be a root and password. The username and password. So the default username will be root and password will be empty. Means not empty, it will be no password you have to type. You have to just press root username and then press enter. Then you should be logging, you should be able to log into your MySQL server database. Okay. So meanwhile, we'll go to the file location, show in folder, just extract here. Let me take some time to extract. So while this installation is being on, it will be asked for you like the default browser is this is the default browser and what is the default editor I have to take, everything it will be asking you. You can directly change it or else no need, it's up to you. So the extraction has been done. Now you could see in this your WordPress, you could see WP admin content, everything. We'll be seeing how to use all this later on. It will be asking you for the another any other web browser you want to make it all like that, but I will be saying no because it will be asking like Internet Explorer. If you want to set your default to your Google Chrome, you can do that, but I don't do. But anyways, we'll be getting a pop-up. Let's check. Yes, see, Internet Explorer will be used as a browser by WAMP server. Do you want to choose another browser installed? I'll say no. If you say yes, it will be asked to set your browser like pop-up. Then you can go to your Google Chrome and do that, but I will be not doing. I'll say no. 20 more seconds, it should ask for that. Yes, allow access for Apache. Allow access, you have to press that and then next. Finish. Okay, so now WAMP server icon is there. So just run this WAMP server, then you will be getting a pop-up like whether you have to allow it or not. Yes, when you see that, you could see here to the below, there is a red color W icon that is slowly changing to yellow, orange, and then it will be changed to green. Once it is green, then it is like, see now it is saying one or two of three services is running. Previously it said no server, then it will be turned to green, then all servers are running. So now your WAMP server got installed and just press here. There is some error path, okay, we'll see. Now just open your local host. Then you could see here WAMP server home page. Here from here you will be doing all your things. So now you could also see in your WAMP server, just open normal click on that. Then you could see here PHP MyAdmin and okay that you leave it. And some directory Apache is there, PHP is there, MySQL is there. So start all services, stop all services, restart all services, everything you could do here. And coming to now PHP MyAdmin, just open this. Now it is coming in Internet Explorer because we have maintained as Internet Explorer as a default browser. Now username will be your root and password is no password and then select go. Okay, we'll keep this aside and now to run our WordPress. So now what is this www directory here? Okay, just to run or whatever the applications of your WAMP, you have to run anything through WAMP server. In your WAMP server, you have to place that particular folder in your www directory. So now let's see what will happen here. See, before that, I would like to show you something like your WAMP server. Here down below you could see here no projects. In your projects folder there is no project. And see here to create a new one, just create a directory in www. So just create here. I will be naming it as Dhaksh. Just rename it Dhaksh. Okay, just open it and just refresh your page. You could see here Dhaksh. When you open this Dhaksh, what will happen? As there is no content available, it should display that part. See, cannot reach this page. No content is available. Okay, and also you can also write here directly Dhaksh. See what happened? Index of Dhaksh, there is nothing. There is no data we have done, so nothing is coming for us. So now let's see how to install our WordPress into this particular by using this WAMP server. So for that, already we have downloaded and extracted our WordPress folder, right? Just copy this WordPress folder and in your www directory, just paste it. Okay, and now no need to rename, you can directly run as WordPress also, but I want to rename it because I will be creating all my what you call these websites, everything into this particular folder. So I want to rename it with my name, so that is Dhaksh Tutorials. Okay, fine. So now how to open this, just to go back to your local host and just refresh your page. What happened? Okay, let's open it again. close this also. It may not be refreshed properly. So now just you can click on here. Here, I don't know why it is not coming for me. So, but we'll be writing here. You can directly write as here Dhaksh tutorials. And then press enter. Now you got your setup. See, if as soon as I press enter, what happened here in my URL, WP admin folder got invoked, and from there is some setup config. So now you have to set your configuration for your WordPress. So just press continue as English, whatever the language you would like. So I will be going for English. So just say English, and then it is asking us to see. Now we need, before getting started, we need some information on the database. You will need to know the following items before go to this. So before going to this, what you would have to do, as we have that phpMyAdmin, just open that phpMyAdmin and set up your whatever the things are, database name, username, password and host and all those things. So how to do this? Here, come here and again log in with root and password is null, MySQL, just go. And now you could see your phpMyAdmin web page. And here, can you see anything to the left side? You could see here information schema, MySQL, performance schema, these are all the default databases. Now we have to create our own database. To do that, it is very simple. Here you could see database name catalog page and just create database. Write down here database. What is it I will be writing? Dhaksh. Yes, to Dhaksh. Okay. And then create. Now database got created, and once you click on this, there is, you will be getting this no tables form, because it's just created database and there are no tables, and no need to worry, the default tables are all what are all required for your WordPress. Everything will be used by your WordPress only. By default it will be installed, it will be creating its own database, the tables, everything. So no need to worry. Now what you have to do here, you say let's go, because our database is ready right now. So what database name, what is the database name I gave? Dhaksh, Dhaksh. And username of your MySQL PA, that is root, and password is empty. Localhost table prefix means what is the prefixes of your table name. By the follow name you can add some prefixes. So right now I will be adding DK, because Dhaksh tutorials, DT I will say, DT you don't need, because it again resembles like date. So DK, Dhaksh tutorials, Dhaksh. So I want all my tables to be installed with the name prefix, allowed with the prefix DK underscore, and then just click submit. If everything goes well, then you will be getting this like, all right Sparky, you have made the part of installation. Now WordPress need to install it your database. So just run the part, click on the run the installation. So now it is asking, what is it, 5 minutes time for your installation. Just fill in the details of below and you will be need. So what is that set title of your website? As it is mine, the Dhaksh tutorials, so I will be writing Dhaksh tutorials as a website. Username, remember this username and password should be used whenever you log in as an admin to do any modifications into your website. So always you have to remember this username. So I will be writing it as Dhaksh17, and you can hide your database. Now it's like a strong data password, so just hide your password and just write down your password. See, I have created my password. It will be showing weak, medium or strong password. It's okay if it is a medium one, it will be asking, giving you some alert symbol saying okay, I will be saying no. So as it is weak, now what is saying, confirm your weak password and click on that. So I will be now writing another password which is weak. Okay, it's very weak, so let it be. So I will be saying confirm use of weak password, but do not use weak password, always use the strong password. And your email ID, so that all the updates, anything occurred for your website, all will be shown here. So dhakshtutorials@gmail.com is my website email address, and then install WordPress. Not for this site, waiting.
So now installation, it's like success, you have made installed. Thank you and enjoy. Username, will be getting username and password, I have to choose it. So just press login and give the same username and password which you have created, right, which you have used. Okay, and then login. Alright, your thing has come to this particular thing. So now just go here and then say visit site. See, this is the default website created by your WordPress, default template and all. We can change all our templates, everything. Just click on this W, you will be getting to your WordPress. And here you can post anything, like you can add some post title, hello world. You can add new post by clicking here, new post. You can write anything. All these things I'll be showing you later on in another sessions. Just log out. After log out, how to log into your particular things. Okay, so just go here. So just close, everything is being closed. Now open your this thing and go to your local host. And here you have Dhaksh tutorials, right? Just write down the Dhaksh tutorials here. Dhaksh tutorials. End and then press enter. So your website gone. You can see your website. And to do any modifications into your website, you have to do new like WP admin. Right? And then press enter. Then you will be getting the login page. Then login by using your, okay, it's not Dhaksh, it is Dhaksh 17, and then Dhaksh 17, and then login. Okay, now you can do all the whatever the modifications you would like to know. So hopefully I hope that you have understood all these things. What we have learned today, we have learned what is a WordPress basic thing and what is a WAMP and how to install WAMP, as well as how to install, how to download and install our WordPress and also run that particular WordPress and give your website or some address. And remember, this is the one way that you can just do your practice and everything by, and you can learn WordPress here. But there is another way, like you can directly go to your wordpress.com. This is one way to install your WordPress, your websites, everything. You can directly go to your wordpress.com and then you can log in there and you can create your web pages, and that pages can be directly hosted and a public can see your websites. And also you can directly use like setup hosting. Hosting on a web server, you can directly do that particular thing. Even that thing helps you to make your website visible to all the users. But this is a third step, like running in our system. Run and install WordPress in our system, in your computer. Okay, this will not help you to run, show your website to the outside world, but you can learn and you can install. After you make everything, pages, everything, then you can host on any web server to make your website visible to the all the users around the world. Okay, I hope you understood this session, and I'll be coming back with another session, how to do the modifications and everything in with WordPress. Thank you. Have a nice day.